up with that kind of thing for a couple of hours when you go out to a restaurant. But imagine what it's like for the people that work there.
Oi, oi, Garcon, Garcon, EC.
When you actually go out to a restaurant, I don't think you realise how much power a waiter has over you, over what happens before your food actually arrives on the table.
A lot of what happens in between that time has a lot to do with what happens at the table and how they treat me as the waiter at their table.
I mean, not saying please or thank you, not looking at me.
Guys lying on the floor of the restaurant trying to look at my skirt.
Walking by a table and being grabbed, like physically.
Men pretending they're looking at my badges and they're actually touching my tip.
Disrespect, you know what I mean?
Clicking of the fingers.
Guys pinch my bum.
Yeah, that's it. Rude fucking people.
Obviously, when things get a little out of control on their side, I can do a few things on my side to make it an enjoyable evening for me.
Real common things are spitting.
I've dropped your food on the floor. I've wiped my dirty hands on your nice jacket from Topshop.
Blowing your nose and getting the snot and rubbing it on the hot dog.
And I've watered down your drinks, quite literally.
The worse you get, the worse the vengeance.
And I unzipped myself and I started peeing in the champagne glass, all the way up to the brim. Peed all the way up to the brim. And I says, there you go, mate. You can have your glass of champagne. You want to have the glass of champagne. There you go, it's yours, take it. He takes a sip of the champagne and says, this is warm. Don't you know anything about champagne?
Someone kept sending the steak back because it was just overdone, underdone, blah, blah, blah. Oh. And he grabbed the next piece of steak and wiped it up his ass.
No.